Sydney, and Austin.
The Great Pacific Garbage Patch was discovered in 1997 by a guy named Charles Moore. There is garbage floating everywhere in this area. The garbage patch is located in the North Pacific Gyre. Animals die all the time there, usually from eating the stuff on the ground or getting stuck in it. Mankind's waste has created an uncontrollable environmental disaster. The garbage patch is almost the size of Russia. Some of the trash came from the tsunami that hit Japan on the 11th of March in 2011. That's not all. There's one floating table of buoys that is sturdy enough to stand on. Some items found in the waters are cups, tires, bottles, glass, fishing tube, rope, camper bins, buckets, steamers, plastic, and basically anything you can throw away. There are often unrecognizable shards of plastic floating around. The pieces are small enough for animals to swallow them, and when they do, they can cut their insides, and that leads to death. Large tangles of rope and plastic often trap fish, causing them to die. The picture of water in the jar on the slide is taken from the center of the garbage patch. It's from the outside edges. The picture with all the junk is stuff pulled from the ocean.
In Australia, 80% of the trash comes from waterways far from the sea. 80% of the ocean trash is plastic. That is really bad because plastic can take up to 1,000 years to break down, and if it's in the ocean for that long, animals will just keep eating it. There are garbage patches in the ocean, and people don't know this because they are too far out to sea from the beach. Animals and humans get affected by plastic. Animals eat the plastic and get sick or die, and humans step on the plastic and can get affected by the bacteria that is on the plastic. So both humans and animals end up really sick. Plastic is especially bad for turtles and seals because they eat jellyfish. And when they see the plastic floating around, they think it is a jellyfish, so they eat it. This causes them to choke, drown, starve, or die. Over 700 species of ocean animals have been reported to have eaten or been entangled in plastic. Scientists have started to figure out that about 8.8 million tons of plastic winds up in the ocean every year. We think everyone should start using reusable materials such as water bottles, metal straws, or even reusing your plastic water bottles. Think before you throw away something, or it's like maybe you can use that thing again. America used to send all our plastic waste to China, but now they don't want it. So this means we should start using less plastic. That will be better for us, our environment, and the ocean. We can all help just by using one less thing.
Plastic pollution is a very big problem in the ocean. Two of the most popular plastic items found in the ocean are bottle caps and food items. Overall, 14,000 tons of plastic enters the ocean each year. The physical features that make plastic usable also make it hard to recycle and hard to replace in our manufacturing. If we recycle plastic, we can have a second chance and we'll make the world better.
We want to keep our water clean. So to keep it clean, we need to start to reuse our plastic items. But if you really want to help, you should not use plastic at all because it is not good for the environment, especially the ocean. 91% of single-use plastic isn't even recycled, but we can help. If everyone started using reusable items, the world would be cleaner. Instead of our water looking like that, our water could look like this or close to this. How can we reduce the plastic waste in the
We can help by going to the beach and picking your trash. Pick up your pet's waste, dump litter, recycle the trash, raise and donate money to organizations that help the water pollution. Buy reusable Tupperwares and buy reusable straws and water bottles. This can have a positive impact on the environment. If you choose to do some of these few things or all of them, you can help all the animals in the ocean and the environment. If most of the world decides to make a difference, we can have a better earth and cleaner ocean.
Our first solution is a sale. You're going to sell reusable water bottles, metal straws, and silicone tips for the straws. Everything will be under $5. You're going to donate all the money to the Four Ocean Company.
We'll also try to convince the cafeteria to stop selling the smart water bottles. The water bottles sit in the fridge for a while, allowing the plastic chemicals to seep into the water. Also, people usually drink no more than half of it and throw it away. They don't even throw it in the recycling all the time.
We chose these solutions because we thought that taking away water bottles would result in less plastic waste from Stuart. We are also doing a sale that includes selling reusable water bottles because if kids can't rely on the cafeteria bottles, then if they don't already have them, they should have reusable bottles to use instead.
Thank you. Any questions?
Your sale, are you going to try to make a profit? Because if you're selling water bottles for under $5, they're like $30, so you're basically...
No, they're not hydro flasks, they're a different
kind. Okay, then they're $20. are you trying to make a profit?
No, all of we're organized who's going to buy what, and we're going to spend all of our money into the corrosion.
So you're saying you guys are going to donate the water bottles?
Yeah.
Yourselves?
Well, we're selling them and the money that we get.
No. For the event. Naomi?
So if people stop using plastic water bottles, what are people who make plastic bottles? Why not somebody do that?
Well, they're going to stop making them.
What are they going to do with the ones before they make?
We're not going to stop using plastic all fully.
Yeah, we're just going to stop Stuart from using so much.